They say starting is always the hardest step.
What?
But we're not starting. We're continuing the adventures of Hearthbar Tales.
Good lord.
Motherfuckers don't know about finishing.
No. We'll never finish this story, maybe. But yeah, here we are. Episode 43, I believe.
Yeah.
43, yeah. 42 yeah. Was The Kids Aren't All Right.
Yes,
I know because I did the graphic this morning.
You did. What's the crack? How are we?
Yeah, it's good. Finances in ruins.
Just in general? Just the world? Yeah.
Just finance as an entity.
Just finance in general?
The economy.
The economy, yes.
Yeah. Don't listen to what this one would tell you.
Yeah. No.
Fucked.
What I would tell you about the economy?
Yeah.
Yes.
Oh, no. I'll tell you that the economy's in bad shape. It's but I will better. Tell you that you can make money in poor situations, in all situations.
Well, where there's a will, there's a way.
You heard it here first. War profiteering. That's the way.
Profit off of the suffering of others.
Jesus,
like
no.
Like the Irish housing market.
I gave you that Kinder Maxi like a good 40 minutes ago, and you've just been treasuring it.
Yeah.
I wait with bated breath.
Yeah, I wonder when he's going to eat it.
I know.
You have to pick what you think is the most dramatic time to eat that. Trentin Tarde.
Like, if Jim's character dies or something.
No, like, Melody dies, just like, our character's weeping over, and it's like, oh, Melody, no!
Or, you know, you fail a roll slightly to, you know, moderately trip up. It's like, aha, time for the Kinder Maxi.
For all you listeners at home, there's often jokes that we have to cut out on in the podcast where, you know, we'll make a joke like that about eating something and then make a lot of, like, aggressive mouth noise. But, like, all our gates and filters cut it all out in post.
Yeah.
So then we just have to remove the joke because it doesn't make any sense.
Well, here's something you can use to edit back in. Well, I guess this might be what I'll have to do, but mouth noises.
Yeah.
And then the listeners can put in their own interpretation of what that means for
them.
Yeah,
I'll just cut that out and put it in there. Mouth noise.
Anyway, welcome back to Leth One and the land of might, magic, and mouth noises, I guess.
There we go.
That saves me one.
Handed you that one. There.
Yeah, I know. Good, because the one I was going to say is actually probably more appropriate to say in the next episode, so it's good, because I didn't have one planned for the next episode.
Yeah.
Anyway, let's do a roll for recap to see what's gone on.
Oh
yeah, dice.
Nelly.
Oh, no. It's a 2.
I got a 3.
Oh my god. Where
that's a 13.
Oh, that would have been really funny if you got a 1 or a 4.
Yeah. It has been so long since you've had to recap.
Yeah, I don't even know what happened. The guys are
Melody and Sin and Bryn walking through the city. I just want all of our recaps to be like the Robin Hood theme song.
It'll happen. Don't worry.
Ryan, if you want to write,
you're not getting
all of
out
them?
Of this.
I will, not right now, but...
Okay, I can just leave a gap here and you can go back and edit it in if you want.
That would maybe be funny.
Well, let me do a really poor recap and you can decide when you're editing later on.
Yeah.
You'd be like, is this better or not?
I'm going to leave us talking about it, though.
Yes, do. It's important that our audience understand the deep thought and effort that we put into this podcast.
Well, Dylan, why would we have you do the recap when I can do it for you? Melody and Sid and Bryn walking through the forest, traveling across the world like a band is meant to do. Came across a circus and made a couple new friends. Oodalolly lolly, always hunting for the hoots. The hoots were in the forest playing with some magic portals. They were shouting, they were shutting them down. But they were killing anyone that saw what they were doing. So the band had to put them in the ground. Bryn and the circus man were sitting by the fire, admitting that neither were telling all the truth. Bryn came clean and the circus man's a dragon friend. Doodle-lolly-lolly, both hunted by the hoots.
Melody and Sid and Bryn walking through the city, picking up a circus tent and throwing rotten fruit. Came across some kids who were looking for the lost friend. Doodle lolly lolly, of course it was the Hoots. The kids were hiding out, they were thinking, they were scheming, they were planning out a hell of a heist. So steal the magic rod in a shed with some baddies, so they do it in the dead of the night. Melody and Sid and Bryn told the kids to stay home. They would save the friend like a band is meant to do. The kids had a name reminding Sid of a lost friend. Doodle lolly lolly, taken from him by the Hoots. Doodle lolly lolly, of course it was the Hoots.
So, our party are now in the dead of night, approaching this shed and kind of like typical like building site, you know, like prefab container kind of buildings that, you know, all of like the tools and workers maybe like sleep there as well. And there are a couple of guards scattered around that you see. You have been traveling with these teenagers and you are just about to
We left the teenagers back.
Yeah, we left them
because we said it was better as a two-man job.
We left them there, okay, but we're gone away.
Okay.
Hey. First off, spring reference today.
Okay. Have you guys
happy about it?
Have you had time to plan the load of these out? Because I haven't.
I mean, house is probably a million miles away, if I had to guess.
Yeah.
Okay. So you guys see these couple of guards that are set up. What would you like to do? How would you like to go about this?
All right. So how many guards are there? Let's count them out here. We've got uno, dos, tres, cuatro,
cinco,
seis.
Right.
You want me to come out swinging or?
You ready for bed, man?
Yeah, sorry. I haven't been sleeping well.
Oh.
Christina has been keeping me awake.
Gross. I was going to offer you some tea.
That's TMI, okay. Brent, okay?
Sorry. Listen, what are we going to do?
So I would say,
well, there's six guards now.
Why did we
leaning into the bit?
How about this, right? We've done a lot of stuff. You've done more than I, but we've all done a lot of stuff. And I think breaking into a shed is never going to come close to the top of the list. So why don't we just cast darkness on the shed and we'll sneak in and get it?
I think that the guards will notice that the shed went dark.
Why don't we cast darkness somewhere else? And when they go to investigate that, we'll break into the shed.
That might work, actually.
Yeah, that would
kind of just off center.
Yeah, just we'll cast. What's the second most suspicious thing on the site?
So this isn't necessarily. This is kind of like a little bit away from the site. They don't want to be, you know, building through where they're sleeping, so they've kind of camped up nearby on like the outskirts of town. But there is like, again, it's like a small shed. It's only maybe a couple of meters by a couple of meters. It's literally just a tool shed, and then there is more of like a kind of like a temporary bunk situation that's set up, like a small quasi-barracks-esque situation that looks like it has maybe a couple of rooms in it. But otherwise, there's not a whole lot there. And then I said there's six guards kind of scattered around, which seems like a lot of guards for what this
An
is.
Infinite digging machine? No, I'd guard that with my life. Listen.
Wait, can Fink burrow? Can his rock form?
Oh, fuck.
Yeah.
Yeah, let's just have Fink get it. Or at least burrow us a passage.
We can go underneath the shed. That's one of the things you gave me.
Yeah. Yeah, it is.
How many episodes do you have planned?
Honestly, for this part, I was just like, this is just how they're going to figure it out. So, you can do that. So Fink, if we do that, Fink will give a stealth check because he is still going to be burrowing under
making
and that
noise, yeah,
and that will make noise and potentially be seen or felt as there's like tremors underground, you know.
How about then we put plan A
would work.
That's a plan.
We put plan A and plan B together, right? And we'll use everybody to do a thing. Okay, so I'll cast darkness over there on those the barracks. Mel,
yeah,
can you use your thaumaturgy? I don't know if this is how it works, but can you make a noise over there like it's someone shouting for help?
Sure. Yeah.
Yeah, and then while we do that, that'll
you
cause
and
a
I
ruckus.
Can just super stealth.
We'll just super stealth and Fink go in under and make us a passage.
Plan C, we distract a couple guards and steal their outfits.
Oh, yeah. We haven't done that yet.
We haven't done that yet.
I mean, that is always a classic.
I just keep changing the ring until I get one of their uniforms. It takes 6 weeks.
Okay, what are you doing then?
I think that, right?
Yeah, so Melody will go off, you know, to like be able... Well, I guess they don't need to be there.
Yeah, they can do it from where we are.
Well, yeah, I've got minor illusion, so I can be kind of a little bit far away and use that to create a sound, so...
How's your... Yeah, because your stealth isn't super high, right?
Oh, I have thaumaturgy too, but that's not what that is. It's a different spell, makes noise. No, thaumaturgy.
Yeah, thaumaturgy makes your own voice. It amplifies your own abilities.
It booms your voice.
Yes. With a minor illusion, I can... Yeah. So I'll often use it for, you know... to simulate a choir kind of effect of sounds from other people, from other directions.
Okay, yeah. So, are we happy?
Yeah, and then you and I... So I'm guessing if this is near a site, like, is there much we can use to, like, sneak around, you know?
Yeah, there's, like, various kind of, like... You see that they've moved a lot of the earth. Like, so a lot of this earth has been, like, excavated. There's, like, you know, piles of materials. They have, like, they've brought in, like, stone and stuff like that to... place down to create this new highway. So there's like various piles of you know, raw materials. There's other like more mundane tools, like there's like wheelbarrows and shovels and things like that are knocking around.
How about you go with Fink like through the tunnel thing?
Yeah.
And then, because if things go wrong,
so Fink can boom away. Fink doesn't necessarily make a huge tunnel. Fink will just kind of like burrow himself. Oh, kind of like more, it's more like an earth glide kind of a situation.
Okay.
Like the way a worm would like burrow through it. He's not like making a little actual tunnel.
No.
He's just tunneling, if that makes sense.
Yeah.
So it is a wooden shed. He could probably break through it, but that'd be fucking loud.
I mean, I could probably just melt the lock if I needed to.
But then,
if you want to give me a perception check to see, try and scope out the locks.
Yeah. Do either of us own like binoculars or anything, or are we just kind of standing with our hands to our eyes?
Ranger vision.
Ranger bullshit vision. Yeah. Yeah.
Okay. Well, let's make some perception checks. Oh, not 20.
Okay.
Yeah, and mine was an 18 plus 5. So
I say with both of you've got over 20. You both see that. The lock on this shed has that kind of very clear indication that it had previously been broken and has now, you know, they've reaffixed a new lock into another location. So you see that kind of like where that wood isn't nearly as weathered, where there was like an old outline and now there's a new one. And you see there's actually not just one, but there's two, and padlocks look really heavy as if there's been break-in attempts before.
Okay, so here's the question. They secured the door, but are there any windows?
There are no windows.
It's just a cement block with a door?
Basically.
And is the door made of wood?
It's not even, it is a wooden shed.
Okay, so Fink could probably bash through the bottom of the banner.
Yeah, we can bash it, we can burn it. We get through. We get in and out pretty quick. What if we do the plan, I get in and I'll just boom out with it?
That's what I was thinking is that if nothing else, like if things start going sideways.
Do you know what? I'll go in, I'll set a fire, I'll boom out. And
how are you getting in now?
I'm just going to... Like, my plan is to destroy the shed.
Okay.
So, like, basically, we're just going to make it look like the machine malfunctioned. I'll go in. I'll set something on fire. I'll steal the machine. I'll boom out and destroy the shed.
You know it's not a machine. You know it's a staff.
Oh, it's a staff.
Yes.
Okay. It'll just make it look like there was a fire and the staff got burned up in it. Do you know what I might do? Is I might bring a stick with me, pre-burned, and leave it there. So they'll just assume that's their precious staff.
Yeah.
Does that work?
Yeah.
We happy?
Yeah. I'm thinking if Melody makes the minor illusion sound like there's like a riot going on or something like that.
Yeah, what could you minor illusion that would most set a shed on fire?
Well, Protesters.
Yeah, I mean, it seems like people would do anything in this town for money, so why don't we take a couple of...
muddy the water even further and make it look like it's the Hoots Force burning shit down?
I don't know if the Hoots Force would burn their own...
Muddy the water. okay.
I think we still have Fink try and get
hold on.
The floor.
No, let's be clever. If we make it look like there was a riot and that something was stolen, the first people they're going to come after are those kids.
Yeah.
Right? Because they're the rebellious youth in the town. So maybe we do go in a little more stealthy.
And I would say with your passive insight from how you guys have been, you know, hanging out with these kids, the fact that it looks like this place has already been broken into.
Yeah.
Or attempted to be broken into anyway. That the kids know that this is where it's stolen. They've definitely tried
before. They've tried it before, yeah.
And are probably known.
They've got a bad habit of this.
Yes.
Mm. See, the thing is that, like... And
you don't want to get them sent to Walla Walla.
No, you definitely don't. But what we do want is to go and dig down and find the secrets of the underground.
You just have their entire discography up there.
I can neither confirm nor deny that.
So, Jim.
Yes.
Wait, sorry.
I
could also potentially be good at, like, picking the lock or something like that.
Yeah.
Or stealing keys from one of them.
Okay. I mean, we both have extremely high stealth scores. So,
yeah.
If you can pick the lock.
Okay, well.
Well, I don't know about picking it, but we can try and maybe we should just steal some keys.
Give me 10 minutes. I will try and. Here, Bren, can I get some of those coins?
Yes, of course.
They take like a handful of gold pieces. I'll go find some people who are willing to take a job, get them to make lots of noise, quasi-angry mob. That'll draw their attention, and then you two do whatever you need to do.
Yeah.
Does that make sense?
Sounds good.
Sounds good?
Yeah, perfect.
It's going to be a slip, sleek, what's the phrase? Doesn't matter. It's going to be a nice operation, Mel. Let's go.
Okay.
It's not going to be a slip operation, that's for sure.
These cuts are too deep for me to...
I don't know. That was just, I forgot words.
Oh, okay.
I
thought you were really trying to just...
No, I was going for an Offspring reference, but then I realized that's just not at all a song.
Okay, so Melody rushes off to do that. You know you've got like 10 minutes or so.
Okay.
Is there anything you want to prepare in these 10 minutes?
So I have an idea.
Yeah.
And I'll chat this through with you.
Okay.
So I've been spending like every night, like, well, you've apparently not been sleeping. I've been, you know, spending a lot of time dreaming and stuff. And I've gotten a little bit of a new ability. And I've actually had it. I've just not used it.
Great.
That's pretty fly. Wait, I'll remember that one.
And and I'm thinking that if we went and talked to the guards, like, you could pretend to be somebody, and like, we can use like the whispers thing, you know, the dream, or, you know, to talk with each other.
Yeah,
the
circle of trust.
Yeah.
The brain space.
And see, the thing is that even if I fail like a sleight of hand check.
Oh yeah.
To get it. Because I can basically use, like, look into their dreams enough to see where he's put it, in where he's put the key in his pocket, or which pocket he's put it in, to kind of help you with this.
Oh, yeah, okay.
Because if I fail, I basically just get to add another D6 onto it.
Mm-hmm.
So, I said that in Sid's voice, but whatever. Sid's like, oh, add a D6. But yeah, so I feel like we have a good chance with... I feel like we'd have a good chance with the checks.
Yeah,
that we
okay.
need to do. Because any of the checks that we do, if we fail them, we basically get to add another D6 onto it.
And you guys are looking at these guards. These are not, like, trained soldiers or anything by any means. These are laborers who have been put onto guard duty.
Mm.
More so, you know? Like, they're not even really carrying weapons or anything like that. They're just keeping an eye out because they know there's like thieves around, essentially. It's not as if you're trying to steal or sneak up on like really, really skilled people here. So you don't think it's going to be too difficult.
I'm just thinking before we do the rest of your plan, if we have the key, then you won't have to like break it or make
break
any
the
noise.
Shed. Yeah. I'm all for it.
So
let's go.
Okay.
So
in the distance, you begin hearing the sounds of an angry mob.
Yeah. So.
Okay. Find one and see if you can find where the keys are.
Yeah. So I guess with...
Give me a perception check to try and see who has the keys.
Can we both do this?
Yeah, sure.
No.
That's a 19.
You don't see any... There's no kind of like stink.
So I failed that check?
No. With a 19, you realize that none of them have it. And maybe it's inside the bunk or something like that. Like... They have the keys kept away. It's not like they need...
The keys on them.
This is kind of like, oh, the foreman or something would have the keys more than anything.
Yeah.
Okay. So that would be two places to sneak in if we wanted to do that.
Mm.
But you are beginning to hear this angry mob, and it's getting closer now, and you see that the guards are starting to look, not worried, but kind of just curious as to what's going on. Bren, what are you doing?
How'd it go, Sid?
None of them have the keys, I don't think.
All right, so we have a choice between sneaking in or breaking in.
Yeah, I mean, if we can sneak our way in, if you're able to melt the locks off, I think that'd be better because we don't want to bring heat on the kids, you know?
I can absolutely get the lock off, 100%. But, like, they're going to know it's been broken into. They're going to know it's been broken into anyway when the staff is gone.
Yeah.
Okay, so the only thing is they're going to think it's the kids that did it because...
I'd just rather it be a little delayed before they find out that the staff is gone, you know?
Okay, so I wonder...
Well, let's try with Fink, maybe, first.
Let's see if... Do you know what? If Fink can just go right up to the door and burrow under, it might be enough for me to just squeeze through. If he burrows back and forth a few times, he can at least loosen the soil.
You can also wear my cloak of shadowy saxophones.
No, I don't need that sax.
That does nothing for your actual
It doesn't have your stealth, but it looks cool.
I have... You gave me your other thing.
Okay, so what's Fink doing specifically? He is...
Gonna burrow. First off, probably just see if, you know, it is wood. Like, is he able to burrow under and get into the shed?
If you want to just give me... So first off, give me a stealth roll with advantage for Fink as he is burrowing under. The advantage from Melody's kind of mob that's causing a lot of ruckus. That's kind of masking some of the noise that might be made by his burrowing.
26.
Yeah. With a 26.
I don't know why you gave me advantage.
No, I get it.
Because you're essentially getting the help action. Yeah. And we've established that Fink's very good at eating. He could probably like claw slash like bite his way through the ground if you give me an attack roll. Okay. If you want to try that.
Can Fink make an athletics check?
That is a nat 1.
Ugh. He just... He's able to eat through.
The taste of sawdust. From
yeah, and it's just whatever way it's angled, his jaws can't get a grip on a flat surface underground, and he just can't get there. But he can return. No one's noticed.
Okay, right. Will I take the lock off?
Yeah.
Okay. First, I'm just gonna axe kick the lock off.
Okay. So the guards are still kind of, they haven't like fully left at this point.
Okay. I'm going to. So tell run you, out and be like,
okay,
you know, help, like, they're getting really violent over there, like, they've started breaking into windows and things.
Yeah, they're smashing all the locks.
Give me a deception check.
10.
I love that Sid has a flat on deception, like, he's not capable of lying.
He's not good at lying. No.
Give me, roll a 2d6 and tell me the lower.
One.
One of the guards runs away to go check.
Okay.
There's still five kind of knocking around.
Fair.
I mean, I'm going to silently axe kick it. No, so we still need to get rid of guards.
Yeah, maybe we do the darkness.
Yeah, okay, fool.
It's not very stealthy. I think if we do darkness, they're going to immediately...
Well, if I cast darkness over where the mob is, right? They're going to run to try and... They think the problem is over there.
They all definitely are looking towards the direction of where there's like a lot of ruckus going from. You think that any kind of... further distraction from that area, it would definitely would work. And you know, Sid has been sent one of them over there, but some of them are a little bit more disciplined and are hanging around because they know
I'm going to cast
suspect some things.
I'm gonna are they both?
I'm thinking even if we just try and sneak around it, you know.
Well, it's like got a door on one side. Because I was saying I'd sneak up to it there, but there's like five guards around it, right?
So, no, they're not all around it, but they're all general kind of vicinity. Like, well, there's like two guards near the shed. There was four kind of like milling about. One of them has gone now.
I'm going to do thaumaturgy on where it's all going on. I'm going to cast darkness. So I'm basically going to cause a cloud of darkness to appear over where all the riot is.
It's minor illusion to get the noise over. There.
Thaumaturgy, I can create an instantaneous sound that originates from a point of your choice range, such as a rumble of thunder, cry of a raven, or ominous whisper.
Cool. Yes. So yeah, it's only 30 feet, but you can be in that general direction so they heard some of it. Yeah, okay. Yeah.
And I want it to basically just sound like violence, like their guys are getting attacked now.
Okay, yeah, nice. Give me a deception check.
Ooh, guess who's specced into deception? That is a 2 on the dice, so 9, but I'm going to use a luck point too.
Yeah. Nice, yeah.
That is a 9, so 18.
18.
16.
Okay, roll me 2d6 and give me the highest.
I hate this game.
6.
6!
All of the guards, like, they all start, like, running around, grabbing, like, shovels and crowbars and, you know, just like various tools and start running off thinking that there's like actual shit that's going down.
Do you want to try your hand? Do you think you'd be able to pick this?
I don't have a tool picking set.
Okay, fine. I axe kick it off the door.
Give me an attack roll.
16?
Yep, 16 hits. You just smack it.
I'm aiming more to break the wood it's attached to than the lock itself.
Yeah, yeah. And that's definitely what happens. Like, the screws are the weak point of this for sure. You crack open the door. Everything else seems to be still going on. You have a look around. It's mostly kind of maybe the more like expensive tools, but kind of in pride of place, as it were.
Yeah.
There is a very distinctly magic looking staff.
Quick, Sid, give me the smut.
Yeah, here.
I forgot about the smut.
Swap it out with the smut.
Yeah, perfect.
I was afraid you were going to forget.
No. So you've successfully traded for this staff. What do you do now? Are you running?
Run!
Okay. Yeah, well, fucking hoof it. I'm going to try my best to kind of like just place the lock back on the door. Oh, I want to try and singe the lock back into the door. If I can, just kind of weld it back on with a...
I don't know if you can weld into wood.
I'm going to burn the place down. Yeah, no, I'm just going to put it back on.
Yeah.
As best I can by loosely pushing the screws back into the holes.
I'll use some of the leather straps that I use for my bows. To wrap on the arrowheads and stuff.
Give me a sleight of hand check.
Actually.
Okay.
This is a construction shed.
Yeah, yeah.
Is there like new screws?
Now you're thinking, Jim.
There we go.
I just gotta screw it back on.
Yeah.
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 All right.
Okay, yeah. Which is the noise Brent makes using a manual screwdriver.
Yeah.
Okay.
Brent, then give me that side of hand check.
Cool. I can help. I'll do a Brent side.
Sure. Yeah. Okay. So, Buddy's the make.
14.
21.
Yeah. You just do it like perfectly. Like it looks, you know, spot on. No sign of it whatsoever. You guys take it, run back towards where the offspring hangout is.
Yeah.
Along the way, you meet Melody, who kind of left the mob to kind of do their thing. And are we?
I am a wizard.
Oh, well done.
Yeah, that was easy. That was real easy. We got away. Do we got to get away? Did we get away?
I think with this,
like the chaos was enough.
With the chaos that you got all the guards away, you don't think you're being chased, so you're.
You're doing very well on these.
Thanks. Yeah, I knew we got away. I just wanted to ask.
I just wanted to ask.
You see that the offspring are waiting around, and Dexter
like, hey, Dexter, come out and play.
Well, dude,
that was my next one. Nice,
dude. Oh shit, you got it? Fucking nice, dudes. How was it? Are they chasing after you?
No, there was a riot.
Yeah.
Oh, fuck, sick.
Tell you what, this is not utopia.
They all look at Declan.
I gotta stop.
Who was the kid that was in the stocks originally. Yeah. And they're all like, see, Declan, that's what you fucking do without getting caught. And like some of them like playfully like shove him and stuff.
Hey, man, like we've been doing stuff for a while. Don't be hard on yourself. You know, and it's good to have like a teammate that you can like fully rely on for everything. You know, that's what makes a difference.
Yeah, for sure.
Well, dudes, look, we're just so happy that you got it for us. So, like, thank you so much.
No, we're not done.
Yeah, okay.
We'll be using the staff. We'll go get your brother.
Sister.
Yeah. Sibling.
Sorry. I just, for some reason in my head, I constantly just think of Mouse from The Matrix.
Yeah, and I keep thinking someone we know from a LARP who's called Mouse. So.
Anyway, your sibling.
Yeah. Okay. Well. Yeah. I'll bring you guys to where the general idea, like area of where we found their brooch, if that works.
Yeah. Cool.
Yeah, for sure.
It's like so. You know, in like a lot of like areas in like central Ireland, there's like tunnel systems that are not in like mountains and stuff. It's kind of just like underground caves and tunnels.
We don't talk about them on air, do we?
But it's more. Those kind of tunnels that they're talking about. These aren't like mining tunnels or anything like that, or caves, like, you know, mountain caves. So Dexter kind of brings you off to this kind of just area outside of town. And you see that there's, you know, just the ground here is completely misshapen. And there's like rocks kind of like, you know, jutting out of and stuff.
This is after the groundworks. I'm asking Dexter.
Oh, yeah. So we used to have like a really cool like system of tunnels and stuff that were really cool to hang out in here. And, you know, we just kind of go in and, you know, we do some like training and stuff. But yeah, dudes, as I said, like all these tunnels then just like moved around one day. And that's where, and that's when we lost Mouse. And then the Hoots Force arrived. They, you know, they were like, oh, don't come in. It's not safe. And then all of a sudden when we went to check on it, the whole place was like completely caved in and destroyed.
Mm.
So, wild. Yeah.
That's not a subtle job.
No, but like, yeah, so that's, you know, everyone else seemed to kind of buy it that it was just like, it was unsafe and there was, you know, the ground had collapsed, but, you know, I don't buy that.
Okay.
No. Seems like some Tom Hootsery going on around here.
Yeah, dude, well, you know.
I okay. love it.
Fuck them hoots, you know?
Yeah, absolutely. Oh, fuck them hoots.
Fuck those hoots. Right, where we going?
Hell yeah.
Yeah.
Later, little dude.
Okay, he like brings you over and he's like, okay, so like pretty sure like right below here is the area that we found their brooch. So like if you can do it.
And it's your sibling, right?
Yeah.
Cool. Hold on, Sid. I got to do something real quick. Wait here. I'll be back in like half an hour. 4 minutes top.
You going to pee?
Yeah.
Oh, well, I guess number two.
I got to go to my special place.
Okay.
I want to bolt back to the circus.
Okay.
Step of the Wind, Monk Shit, Parkour, Assassin's Creed.
Just before we do any of that, you would know that you can't actually use the staff yet. You need to wait until dawn before it like recharges.
Of course. Yeah, yeah.
Why'd you bring this all the way out here when this wasn't ready to go? Sorry.
Well, I was just showing you where it was. So, you know, you guys were really, you know, just like enthusiastic about it. And I didn't have a chance to say no.
You get a head start. Start digging manually. I'll be back.
Think.
Oh, can Fink tunnel around and...
Can you have a look in there before we start?
Can Fink find the portal?
Fink has used his ability now to...
No, he didn't. He just kind of... His normal form, he scratched and scratched on this.
No.
No, he was burrowing.
He burrowed.
Oh, yeah. I thought because you were like...
I didn't know the burrow was only once a day.
He has to use an attack roll to burrow under the ground?
No, but he can just burrow under the ground.
No, the attack was to get through the wood.
They have... Wood on the floor of the construction shed. That's insane. Okay, let's go.
Yeah, the shed.
Yeah, I just, in my head,
shed has
it was
a floor
like
a, too.
Yeah,
I mean, I know sheds do, but it's just because it was like a shitty shed and the construction site, but I'm glad we got in and out. He was clearly more of a fortress than I thought.
Or are you saying he's changed back?
Yeah, it's been well more than 10 minutes at this point by the time you've gotten to the, because they are at the other side of the town and they have to go to this. But as Dexter brings you to this area to kind of show you where it is. Bren, you, as you get closer to it, you feel like quasi-like resistance to your steps?
I'm finding it hard to walk. Like I'm walking against the tide?
Kind of, yeah. It's not physically slowing down, but you kind of just like, there's like this kind of like a wave kind of hits you of like a little bit of like a fuck off energy, you know, where just you just don't feel, you feel very uneasy and not, I'm not welcome. You're not feeling that.
Sid, I think there's some kind of enchantment here. Something
and you look at magic. Fink and he's also kind of getting, he's look kind of unhappy about being in the area.
Oh, huh.
Well, can that I, definitely can seems I like roll something... like Arcana or something to try and work out what's going on?
Yeah, you can't.
It seems like something that the Hoots would do though to keep people away.
Just trying to see if I have anything better than
to keep the Fae away.
Yeah. Now, how do I justify an acrobatics check?
You don't. You physically don't.
Okay. Flat roll. You can look at the dice. For you at home.
I mean,
hasn't extrapolated what has gone on. I rolled a nat 20. This dice is doing me good today.
You think back to
the wave of energy.
No, you think back to the forest.
Yes.
And the portal there and what the Hoots Force there were trying to do.
Yeah. See, because they closed it off so we can't... They don't know how to close them. So they just put on a repelling thing so it keeps people from the other side from coming through.
All right. But it's kind of doing the same here.
It's kind of, yeah. You kind of...
Like we're opposite ends of a magnet trying to push.
Yeah, there's something that whatever magic has... affected this ground that you remember being referred to as a hallowing has tiny bit of an effect on you. nothing that's like physically stopping you, but you're just innately aware of it, whereas Cid, you're not.
Cid, my shoulder blades feel tight, and I don't like this, but it's definitely something that the Hoots Force have done.
Yeah, that makes sense. Like, I mean, they were setting up that repelling thing, you know, because they're too stupid to know how to actually close them.
Okay.
So they have to put on a stay away, please.
That's fucking pathetic.
Yeah.
Well, let's not be deterred. I can be a little ill at ease.
Yeah, that's I figure, you know, we'll just do what we did before. Like, we can probably undo whatever dumb shit they're doing if it's stopping you from actually being able to go through the portal.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah, with a nat 20 on your account check, you don't think it's going to stop you from going in. It's just that
I get a sense for it existing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's
probably because there's a little bit of the Fey realm in me. The last time I went there, I did some sick parkour, remember?
Hmm.
Now I got faster. Same with Fink.
You can eat and shit.
Yeah.
And Dexter is kind of just standing there being like, cool, dudes, I don't understand half the shit you're saying.
Well, we said all that part still in the brain.
Okay.
Yes. Anytime we're talking about the portals or the...
It's nice.
Yeah.
And Dexter's like, okay, so dudes, yeah, as far as I know, the staff, look, it won't work until the next morning. I've had a little bit of training in like magic and stuff. So I think you're going to need to attune to this item to get it to work. I can do it if you want, and I can move the earth, but like...
No, one of us will do it, because if somebody detects magic and realizes you're attuned to it, you're going to be on the hook for what happened over there.
Dudes, we can run. We can like run interference.
It's better that we hold on to it.
I, as Ryan, don't want to give up any of my attunement slots.
Well, Mel can attune to it, surely.
Yeah, I could do it.
I'm just worried about... I think Jim is too, putting these kids in danger's way.
I'm actively telling them to go away.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like...
Oh, I get it. Yeah. No, I think we both want the kids to just be all right.
Be out of... Not underfoot, like.
Yeah. In fact, hey, can you guys go hang around the corn market and just be seen so you're off the hook for this?
Yeah, I guess that makes sense. You want maybe one of us just like kind of keep an eye out here in case they come?
Yeah, post a watch, but whoever's your stealthiest fellow.
Yeah, maybe like people know your little band like of troublemakers.
Well, yeah.
Yeah, maybe like pretend like you're trying to steal some like...
There's a shop selling something. Smut.
Yeah, there's a smut shop.
Dude, we know the smut shop.
Yeah, get yourself.
We are all banned.
Yeah, don't get like yourself thrown into the racks again tomorrow, you know.
Yeah, we don't want that.
But like, make it look like that was your plan tonight, was to try and sneak in there.
Okay, we can do that. Yeah, cool. And he goes and gathers the crew, and they all go and start just making trouble.
Yes, like Cid, those kids are terrible criminals.
They're not very good at being criminals, no.
They're not. Okay, so what, we go,
get, I
go,
want, we, them, go I get, want them bad, you know?
Well, we go get some sleep before dawn. There's still a few hours.
Yeah, that's like probably a good idea. Sounds like sleepy pants here needs some sleepy
pants.
Yeah,
Brian, what's up with you? I get the yawning and stuff. It's making everyone else yawn.
Yeah, well, you know what? It's late. Let's just retire, okay?
It took two times for me to realize Jim hadn't just abandoned all mic etiquette.
Yeah.
But Jim is doing a bit here, people sleepy. At home. We apologize for any yawns caused by this episode.
Yeah, don't listen to this while driving, please.
So, yeah, you guys head back to your camp. What do you do?
I want to go talk to Vespuccio.
Okay. What, is Cid or anything you doing?
You want to come?
I'm going to, because we can feel the portal here now, you know?
Yeah, you know where it is, yeah.
Yeah, I'm just wondering if I should still use my charge for the day to see if I can get anything of the kid.
I mean,
Mouse.
If you don't spend it now, you're not going to get as much next year, so...
Yeah, exactly. So, yeah.
Yeah.
Just figured that might be a good idea. Good use of it.
You do that when you're in the vicinity, you don't get anything. You would reckon...
At least now we know...
If Mess is on another realm...
Planes.
Yeah. Nothing's going to happen. Sid, or Bren. Oh, Right. Well, oh.
I do want to...
I'm being interrupted.
Sorry. While I'm doing that, I do kind of want to be looking at Bren. Like, is Bren fully Bren? Is...
Give me a wisdom check.
13.
Bren does appear to be fully Bren. Yeah.
All right, go on.
I've gone full Bren.
Bren.
Hey, Vespuccio.
Yeah.
Quick one. Just yeah. In case you're interested.
Okay, it's late.
It is late.
Yeah.
It is late.
Where have you guys been? You got off and causing trouble?
Yeah, exactly that.
Okay, that's good. Yeah. Don't get any trouble here, please.
We got some kids involved in crime.
Great.
hey, tomorrow, we're going to get in more trouble.
Okay.
We're going to dip in to the Fate Realm.
Oh, yeah. You were talking about, like the place where you're in the forest?
Yeah.
Okay.
There's another portal here.
Right? Okay.
And we're going to go into it. Now, the last time I was in the Fae Realm, it was, as far as the eye can see, plains. And I dropped my visage, and nobody cared what I was there. If you wanted, you could come with us and stretch your wings and fly in a realm where the Hootsforce don't exist. You could fly and be a dragon for a little while before we come back. I say that, obviously, very quietly.
Yeah. Oh, well, I don't know. It's, I'm kind of trying to keep, you know, low key, but mate, do you not think that, you know, having a dragon, even in the Feywild, might cause a bit of a stir?
I don't know. I couldn't tell you. I mean, the last time I went there, everything was kind of over the top anyway. You know, there was a clop along. There were like elves that looked like the seasons. There was a big castle with a flourished D on it written in cursive. You know, it seemed like a pretty whimsical place. Maybe you'd go unnoticed. Well, not unnoticed, but unquestioned? I don't know. It's your risk to take. I'm just letting you know the option is there.
Give me a persuasion check.
Ooh, I'm not trying to persuade him. I'm just letting him know.
Yeah.
I know, but it's how...
It's tempting for him. It's,
yeah.
Yeah.
Do you want me to change my dice still?
Maybe. These dice seem broken. Maybe around that dice.
I've often rolled with this dice, but that's a nat 20, Dylan.
Wow.
Maybe it's the fans from my laptop are just buffeting it over to 20 every time. I rolled a nat 20 on a persuasion check I wasn't trying to make.
I think that a nat 20 means that Vespuccio
is going to make the best decision for Vespuccio.
The best decision for himself, and he's going to, weigh out all of his options and not be swayed by emotion or anything.
Yeah, I think that's he's with a nat 20, you are speaking very, very earnestly to him, and he fully believes that you think it's a safe place for him to be.
I don't know that though. I'm very open that I don't know if it's a safe place for you. I'm just knowing the last time I went there, I was able to drop my visage and be who I was for a little while, and I found that very freeing.
Okay, well, you know, we don't know if it's going to be the same place that you arrive in, so why don't you
come as a gnome? And if you get the vibe of the place, you know, you can make the decision when you're there.
When are you going?
Tomorrow morning.
Okay, that's only in a few hours, but okay. I come as a gnome, and we see what we see.
Cool.
He's like, but I need to go to bed. It's like 3 a.m.
Yeah. Okay.
He goes back to sleep. Sid, you...
I'm in a dreamscape, so I'm basically asleep anyway, so now I've gone to sleep.
Okay.
Well, I mostly just want... Those are my two things I want to see. Unless you're going to tell me something about my dad, but...
No.
All right. Well, then.
You got a 13, right? No.
Yeah. I also wasn't really looking for my dad this time.
Yeah.
Bren is going to... go into the tent with Christina. See, she's asleep, and he is going to pour himself a cup of coffee. He's going to heat it with his little flame, and then he's going to spend the night training instead. Just like drilling katas and doing press-ups.
Give
me
a constitution saving throw.
You fool, I have infernal constitution. That is... 17.
You're very, very tired, but like... that something within you is kind of keeping you going, but you know you can't keep this up
forever.
You know?
Don't have to. Sid will
So it'll work something out.
Sid, you're, you know, brain spacing out with your Professor X style brainwaves into the Dream Theater. And we've been kind of like very soft in how we're kind of defining what the Dream Theater is.
Because Sid doesn't know much yet.
No.
He's new.
So you're essentially just like probing around with your psionic abilities, essentially, kind of amplified by this circle of the Dreamer. And at a base, so your psionic abilities are kind of what let you do things like summon your dream think, kind of mark things with your hunter's mark and stuff like that. These are all kind of like things that you've kind of innately been able to do without knowing that you're accessing kind of dream powers and dreamer abilities for this, you know?
Yeah.
And also, you know, to communicate with people. And, you know, through your kind of 6 months of training with your mother, you've kind of begun to realize that and accept that. And, you know, she's explained as like, this is what's, you know, this is tapping into what the dreamers called the Dream Theater. But she also had explained that, like, you know, other scholars may refer to this as like the ethereal realm. And you know that this kind of dreamscape lies like a veil across the material plane. So not everything is like a full reflection. And so you can, with this circlet on, you can kind of usually project out a little bit more than you would. And this is kind of what's letting you cast like locate person or locate creature, whatever the name of the spell is. And you've been doing this now for a couple of nights.
Yeah.
As you've been traveling, you know, hoping to kind of pick up any sort of...
A while now, because we've been traveling a week or...
Yeah, a week and a half probably.
So yeah, you've like been traveling every night.
Yeah. Even using this to try and sense any sort of residue or like remnant of your father, but, you know, without a memento or like a memory, or even like a drawing of him, it's proving incredibly difficult. Maybe impossible.
Yeah.
So a couple of ideas kind of come to your mind as you're doing this. You know from like Stormzy's research and from like kind of your initial foray into the Feywild that much like the Dream Theater, other realms are often posited to be reflections of the material one. So when you enter this portal back in the forest, you arrived in a forest.
Oh, I see. Okay.
You know? And while it's not exactly one-to-one, there's very kind of like loose... If there's a valley here, there's probably a valley
in the others.
In other ones. Same with mountains, forests, kind of large geographical features. The detail of those probably changes, but again, like a blanket placed on it, it's kind of a rough impression.
Okay.
So you think that, like, well, if you're in this Feywild, that might glean other ways of looking at it too.
Okay.
Give me a wisdom saving throw.
Saving throw. 17.
And you know, this, you had other kind of thoughts are coming to your mind, but like you are pushing them down as to how you might use your dream abilities more. And you kind of, you're disciplined enough in your own mental fortitude and your training to ignore them.
Okay.
Essentially.
Yikes. But okay.
Here we go again.
I'm guessing my... Yeah. Leave me the fuck alone. my mom has taught me, you know, in the time that I was there. I mean, I was mostly focused on the Hoot studies and stuff, but mom brought me into the circle being like, no, before you go again, there's shit you need to know because it's manifested in more than just being able to eagle eye people, you know,
as
a hunter. Surely, like, dreamers learn, like, passive defenses and stuff first that, like...
Or maybe, you know, Sid's big on mantras and stuff. So maybe just like, this is what you do when you're in. This is what you do.
Yeah.
Like she said, you know, go in, always have a goal when you go in. And Sid's just like, okay. You know, maybe wasn't told the scary reasons why not, but just.
You were told at least one of the scary reasons.
Bellicor?
No.
He was a pretty scary reason not to go in there.
You remember being told that it is potentially very alluring for a dreamer to get lost into Dream Theater.
Oh, yeah.
And to appear beyond what is kind of immediately there. And that there was an old professor who went mad and left him.
Yeah.
This is a good callback from like fucking 30 episodes ago.
Only 10. Yeah. But you're very mentally rigid, shall we say, and kind of you cast locate person, can't find anyone, do a little bit of scouting to see if there's any kind of like remnants.
Just looking out for Bren.
Yeah. You see Bren, you see him, and but that's it. Is there anything else you do before in your couple of hours of prep?
No, go sleep.
Okay. Bren, you're just up training, but you're...
Yeah, I just kind of, as the sun comes along, I just get up and go out, get some fresh air.
Yeah, you guys wake up just before dawn, head back over. Melody's attuning to the staff then?
Yeah.
Melody has attuned to the staff kind of in this short rest, and you see that they begin moving the earth, and it's like a very kind of slow process. This isn't like an instant excavation. You see it like very carefully guides the earth and like shapes it in like quite a large area. But luckily you know exactly where you need to go. You bring it down. You see that it moves down in this like small kind of crater that's been made is a portal.
There's the portal.
Yeah.
Shall we go in?
I think we should close the earth behind us.
Yeah, for sure. Very obvious trail left there.
Yeah, we should probably not be seen.
Ah, you're here.
Yeah, sorry, I came. I invited Vespucci.
Hey there.
Yeah, I mean, this is kind of exciting. I don't know what to expect, but...
Hey,
Sid, before we go in there, there's something I have to give you.
And I'm going to take the ring off my finger.
Is it a cup of coffee, Bren? You need to get your shit together. What's...
Sorry, yeah. Yeah, well, fuck you too, Mel. I'm going to take the ring off and give it to you and be like, it's flipped in there. They don't like humans.
Oh.
You got to be something else when we're in there.
Oh, weird.
So, this is my most prized possession, Sid. I need you to hold on to it, but, you know, put it on and off a few times until you get something that's not a human.
Yeah, I take the ring and I, like, kneel down so I'm, like, face to face with Fink.
Yeah.
And I pop the ring on and go...
Thinks he's...
What's Fink see?
Probably not that. Going off Letho on. She's an 89-year-old female drow.
Fink gets a little bit scared, but has seen Bren transform and knows what it is, so isn't too affected. And after a set, he gets a little startled just by the sudden noise, but then comes over and just licks your face.
Cool. Well, there, Sonny. How are you?
Yeah, I found you don't really have to. You don't have to do the accents.
Oh, but it's fun.
Okay, I'm sure we're all not going to regret this in 5 minutes.
Yep. I just pull it off his finger and put it back on again.
Oh no, what am I now?
I don't know what a troglodyte is, so you are a 16-year-old dragonborn.
Okay. God, yeah. Fuck dragonborns.
Okay, yeah, so you're a young dragonborn. And yeah, you...
Like nudge Vespucci and go, hey dad.
Ah, shut up, I'm way too young to have a kid. Melody is able to use the it takes a few like a solid like 20-30 minutes to kind of like un-excavate it a bit.
Yeah.
But has left a cavern that you can
a little bit
come
of
back into.
A breathing room as
yeah,
come back
yeah,
out.
Yeah. They look at you and they go, okay, we
is
we,
Fink in ready? Pain?
Fink's not in pain, but does not look super comfortable.
How intense am I feeling it now that we're stood next to the portal?
It doesn't seem to be proximity to the portal itself. Okay. It's just like an area of effect.
Yeah.
That, again, just kind of like...
A no-no zono.
Yeah. As if there's like a small, like a curtain or a veil or something you have to go.
It's like when shops put that noise that's real high pitched that only like rowdy teens can
yes,
hear.
Yes, exactly.
Yeah.
And you enter into this portal, and on the other side is very, very dim and dark.
Oh.
You are in a tunnel of some sort, and you're here kind of just from down the down one end of this tunnel, like a really like intense like sniffing like.
Did Fink go in ahead of us?
No, it's earthbenders.
Yeah, secret tunnel. Can I roll perception just to try and see if I can get any sense of what it might be?
Yeah, sure. And you can roll perception on this.
I really thought this was going to be a we'll find out next time. But I think that's just down the line. 14.
14 as well. Is that fail or pass?
You can roll a d6.
17 then.
With a 14, you recognize this as very, very animalistic. Like something like wild. But with a 17, I think Sid, particularly you, who are used to like hearing animal noise and stuff, recognize this as maybe more inquisitive than defensive.
Oh.
And you walk a little bit closer to it, and there's like some lights from the back, from the end of this tunnel. So this figure is kind of like backlit. Mm. And as you go a little bit closer, you see this like badger man just in a waistcoat and a little bowler hat. And he's like, hello?
It's Narnia. We went the wrong way. We ended in Narnia.
What have we got here?
I am a dragonborn, as you can see.
Oh, excellent. I'm a badger man. What are you?
And have you ever seen anything like me? We're doing this whole thing in rhyme, just so you know.
I have not seen anything like you.
Oh, well, that makes me sad.
No, but now I get a better look at you. There's some kind of talk going around of someone who kind of matches the description from a little, journey over the mountains. And so little one of our clip-clop-along friends had spread the word that he'd gone riding with someone who kind of looked a little bit like you.
Are you speaking about Georgie?
Ah, yes, you know Georgie. You are him, so... Come, come! Would you like to join an insurrection?
I mean, that's yes. Right up my alley.
Absolutely we do.
What is the source?
Wait,
what
who are we insurrecting against?
Fucking Wenceslas!
Oh, yes, okay.
That's your brother, Vespuccio.
What? No! It's my brother!
You're...
Wenceslas and Ambrosia. You're Ambrosia!
Welcome to my den!
it's gnomes. It's the gnomes. Are we fuck the king?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay, I'm in. I'm 100% in.
What is this?
You know that band that's just gnome?
Oh, yeah.
And they have a song called Wenceslas, and it's just like, fuck that devil king Wenceslas.
Yeah, okay, yeah.
Oh, so it sounds like we've moved quite far away from... Where I emerged the last... How far away are we from Georgie? Where I...
Oh, leagues and leagues and leagues.
Okay. Cool.
Yes, I want to say a completely other kingdom. One free from the evil yoke of that fucking bastard Wenceslas.
Okay, yes.
Anyway, come. It's insurrection time, but first we must feast.
All right, yeah.
Okay, yeah. Sounds good.
And he kind of guides you up. He's like... to this like large hall, and there's just like just huge scene of feasting, and you see all of these gnomes around, and they all have these fucking stereotypical just like dome like pointed hats.
Yeah.
Like all of them just wearing like the exact same clothes. They're all just like essentially like a carbon copy of each other, and they're all just like standing around doing like stupid little dances and stuff.
Incredible.
And he's like, come sit down, pride of face, you're my guest, sit down.
Yeah,
I'll sit.
Take
seats.
Stoked.
Yeah. And, you know.
So he's the only, like, badger man.
Yes.
The rest are all just, like, gnomes.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, we're gnomes.
Oh.
Is it okay if we're gnomes? You also have a gnome here. Yeah, he's missing a hat.
He's our
boy. And they get a one of these, like, red pointy hats and they put them on.
They're party gnomes.
On Vespuccio.
Suits you.
I kind of like the hat. I'm more afraid of a nice silly hat.
Party gnomes. Very good.
Yeah, party gnomes.
Ambrosius is like, fuck, what was Ambrosius's voice?
He was like,
Vespuccio fucked me.
He was like a distinguished British.
It's me, Ambrosius. Yes, please, you're my guest. Sit down. Please eat all of this food. Eat. Let's go.
I'm not really hungry, but I do appreciate the food.
You simply must.
I know what this is, but I'm going to eat anyway because Sid doesn't know.
Bren doesn't know not to eat.
Yeah.
Yeah. Fine. Yeah, I guess I could eat.
Fink is obviously eating.
Yep.
Fink eats first, though. Yeah, I eat
Fink
the food.
Eats first.
I just do the thing. Yeah, I eat the food.
We do the thing.
Yes, you don't know about fey trickery in this world yet.
God damn it.
Okay. And so there's like, you know, there's a little band in the corner just like playing like stoner rock. So I need you to write that for that scene. Okay.
Okay.
Just like riffs on riffs on riffs all the time.
Yeah.
And after a while of like feasting and stuff, they all kind of just stand up and it's like, okay, it's war time. And they all just start like, they all like out of nowhere grab all these like spears and halberds and kind of just like start stamping them on the ground. And then Bros just kind of turns to you and goes, ah, yes. And of course, as you have accepted my guest, you are now obliged to do as I say in return of the favor for the food and hospitality I've granted you. Welcome to my army. And that's where we'll end that episode.
Jesus Christ. I mean, I'm all for it. I love it. I'm all for it.
Yeah, I was like, I know exactly what this is.
Yeah. Like, and I was like, Bran, would Bran have any way in knowing? And it's like, no, he doesn't know anything about the Fey realm.
Yeah. Sid wouldn't. Sid would always accept food because, you know.
Yeah.
He's an idiot, so.
Yep.
Okay, yeah. Let's get with the war, I guess.
Yes.
Cons call out.
Okay. First, some messages.
I was about to say, we have things we need to sell.
Yeah, we have one very important thing we need to sell. 13th of July. It's a Saturday. If you're in Dublin or in Ireland or anywhere within the flight of Ireland, because we know of at least three people coming from abroad to see our live show in Smock Alley Theatre on Saturday the 13th of July. Tickets are on sale now. This is coming out in like a month's time, so there will be less tickets on sale than there was at the time of recording this. So definitely go check that out. The link is in the episode description. It's in our socials. You'll see us talking about it. We'll have super cool posts and posters around. Definitely come check that out. And other than that, also check out our Patreon, because hey, we'd love any support that you can give us. If you can't afford any monetary support, that's okay too. Just leave us reviews and leave us comments, shout out, shares. Just telling a friend is worth so much for us. But if you are a Patreon, you'll get access to Cons Callouts, which are gonna happen
right now. Okay. Oh my god. Hiya, how's it going? I am Con and I'm dead, but I'm here to do some callouts. So first off, Luke, how are you getting on? Always nice to read your name on the podcast. I hope today finds you well. Kira, always a pleasure. I can't wait to see you on the LARP field not too long from now. Potentially already happened when this releases?
Yes.
Yeah, so not Jim, but you keep an eye out for Con Greystone on that LARP field. Rookie DM would like to very quickly have to commiserate Dylan for having to put up with even more of Ryan and Jim's shenanigans. So
I like the shout out.
Yeah, so you. There you go. And I make no apologies. Dread, how are you getting on? Well done on the incredible archery I've been seeing. Sorry about your boob. Quadruple Bacon has sent me with a very serious message today to the Demigods group. Cassian is coming for you. Heed my words. This is happening. Welshlander, how are you getting on? We really should meet up, have a pint, and talk about whatever gods it is we worship. And then finally, Keith, the man in the castle who's got an incredible story to tell. We all love you. Keep doing what you're doing. Con Greystone out.